In this video, we will talk about the factors affecting venous return. Let's get started. Venous return is the volume of blood that returns to the heart every minute. It's important to understand factors affecting venous return because venous return, in turn, is one of the factors that affect cardiac output. The more the venous return, the more the cardiac output. Now let's see the factors that affect the venous return. These factors are pumping by the heart itself, or in technical words, venous pressure, sympathetic activity, venous valves, muscle pump, respiratory pump, and cardiac suction effect. Now let's see how each factor affects venous return in more detail. First, the pumping by the heart. As the ventricles contract, they push the blood into circulation. Now, as the circulatory system is a closed circuit, this push naturally tends to make the blood return to the heart on the opposite end. This pushing is driven by pressure along the vascular circuit. We know that pressure in arteries is about 120 millimeters of mercury. Much of this pressure is lost in small diameter vessels. But we still have about 15 millimeters of mercury pressure in veins. And the pressure in the right atrium is near 0 millimeters of mercury. This pressure gradient drives the movement of blood from veins to the heart and thus determines the venous return. Obviously, the more the venous pressure, the more the venous return. So this is how pumping by heart, or venous pressure, affects the venous return. Next, sympathetic activity. Venous smooth muscles receive sympathetic innervation. When stimulated by these neurons, they contract, causing constriction of veins. So pressure in veins increases, and more blood flows from the veins to the heart. Thus, sympathetic activity increases venous return. The next factor is venous valves. In a standing position, gravity tends to pull the blood down. Thus, gravity tends to decrease venous return. However, the effect of gravity is countered by valves in the veins. Yes, veins have one-way valves that allow only upward flow of the blood. If the blood tries to go back, the valves close and prevent the backflow. Thus, venous valves counter the effect of gravity and help in venous return. The next factor is the muscle pump. Many veins lie in between skeletal muscles. When these muscles contract, they compress the vein. So there is a local increase in pressure inside the vein. This opens the valve towards the heart, and the blood in this segment of the vein is pumped up. See, the increased pressure also tends to push blood down. But this results in the closure of the lower valve. So the backflow is prevented. The net result is a movement of blood from the middle segment to the upper segment. Now, when the muscles relax, the vein expands. So there is a local fall in the pressure. At this point, the blood from the upper segment tends to flow back. But the closure of the upper valve prevents the backflow. On the other hand, the valve on the lower side opens, and the vacuum in the middle segment sucks the blood from the lower segment. So there is a net flow of blood from the lower segment to the middle segment. With the next contraction, the cycle is repeated. The upper valve opens, and the blood is pushed into the upper segment. And with the relaxation of muscle, the lower valve opens, and blood is pulled up from the lower segment. Thus, the ongoing activity of adjacent muscles pumps the blood towards the heart. This increases venous return. And this pumping is called a muscle pump or venous pump. When the muscle activity stops, this pumping also stops. So this was muscle pump. Now the next factor, the respiratory pump. Because of the respiratory activity, the pressure in the chest cavity is negative. On the other hand, the pressure in the lower region of the body is normal atmospheric pressure. Thus, there exists a pressure gradient from the lower region of the body to the chest. This gradient pulls the blood from the lower region into the chest. This in turn increases the venous return to the heart. This effect is enhanced during inspiration. During inspiration, the diaphragm contracts and moves downwards. This results in expansion of the chest cavity. So the pressure in the chest becomes even more negative. At the same time, the content of the abdomen is compressed. So the pressure in the abdomen increases. Thus, the pressure gradient from the abdomen to the chest becomes even stronger. So, more blood is pulled, and the venous return increases. This mechanism of respiratory activity contributing to venous return is called a respiratory pump. Now the last factor, the suction effect of the heart itself. When the ventricles relax, the pressure in the ventricles falls. So they suck blood from the atria. The atria in turn pull the blood from veins. Thus ventricular relaxation contributes to the venous return. This sucking business happens during contraction also. See, when the ventricles contract, the atrioventricular valves are pulled into the ventricles. This results in a decrease in pressure in the atria. So atria pull blood from veins. Thus, the pumping activity of the heart sucks blood in and thereby contributes to venous return. So these were all the factors affecting venous return. Now let's have a quick summary. The pressure gradient from veins to the heart drives blood flow from veins to the heart. Sympathetic activity causes vasoconstriction and thereby increases venous return. Valves and veins counteract the effect of gravity and help in venous return. Activity in nearby muscles increases blood flow in the veins by a mechanism called a muscle pump or venous pump. Respiratory activity creates negative pressure in the thorax, which helps pull the blood from the lower extremities. And finally, the suction effect by the heart itself also contributes to the venous return. That's it for this video. You can find notes on this topic and explore our entire animation video library on our website. The links are in the description. If you find our content useful, hit like, comment, and share it with your friends and colleagues too. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.